guys, this is Mark. I want to talk to you today about praying with one of your family members or one of your relatives. Just giving them a call. Maybe it's a relative you haven't connected with in a while. But basically, just asking them, how can you pray for them? And, you know, sometimes family, relative seems to be the hardest people to reach, honestly. And, you know, for me, when I think about that, I think about who could I call that maybe I haven't talked to in a while? And like, man, how do you start up the conversation again? Hey, it's been a long time and I'm sorry. Or, you know what, gee, I've been ignoring you. No, I really haven't. But how do you break the ice? Well, I think a couple things might be real practical for you. And praying for your relatives is really one of the easiest ways to break down those walls to share the gospel. And, you know, immediate family seems super obvious, you know, your immediate family and praying for them. But, you know, what about your aunts and uncles? You know, what about nieces and nephews? And a lot of times as we drift apart as family, just because maybe they live far away, maybe you don't get together as often, maybe the COVID season separated you for a while, maybe it's a different season. Think about those kind of things. It might be a good idea just to jot them down. Just even jot down their names, thinking it through, and because really the goal would be to share the gospel maybe and pray for all of our relatives. So maybe you can't pray for them all in a day, maybe you can't pray for them all in a week, but maybe over a month or two, maybe you can just purpose to set aside some time to contact your relatives and just really ask how you can pray for them. Are there any relatives that you haven't connected with in a long time? Maybe you're not really sure why. You know, there's people that come to mind, you're like, I'm not really sure why I haven't talked to them literally in months or maybe even years. And then there's those relatives that you know exactly why you haven't connected with them, because maybe you don't like them. Maybe they've offended you. Maybe you've offended them. You don't know why you haven't really talked. But I want to talk about this as a matter of fact, because this is a way for us to connect with them, to maybe rebuild or rekindle some relationships that you maybe had with some relatives. Maybe you once were pretty close, but now you've drifted apart and it's like, yeah, you know, they really said some things at the last family reunion that I didn't really care for. Maybe they had some opposing viewpoints. But you know what? Maybe the Lord's been knocking at your door to make a reconnection. Maybe you need to pray for them. And so how do you open that door? So I want to share with you a couple of scripture passages that might help you along in this. The first one comes out of Matthew chapter 6. Jesus is talking about forgiveness. Maybe there's some unforgiveness between the two of you. And maybe it's not your fault. And it doesn't matter whose fault it is, obviously, because here's what Jesus has to say in verse 14. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. It really comes down to the bottom line. So you know what? You, Christian, brother, sister, maybe the ball's in your court. Maybe you need to make that first step. Maybe you need to reach out, make a phone call. Hey, listen, I know it's been a long time since we talked, but you know, I'm just unctioned of the Lord. I'm just kind of nudged by the Lord today. How can I pray for you? How can we begin to mend fences? Maybe you have to own up to that period of silence, but you know what? Take the first step, reach out, give them a call, and say, you know what? Hey, I've been thinking about you today. I just wanted to reach out and bless you and offer you a prayer. You know, a practical way that you can actually reach out to one of your relatives that maybe you haven't talked to for a long time. Maybe it's like a second cousin. Maybe it's like Vinny. You know, hey, I haven't talked to Vinny in like a long time. You know, the last time we talked, it wasn't really all that good. But how do you break the ice? How do you reach out to Vinny? How do you make this strange phone call out of nowhere and say, hey, Vinny, you know, it's cousin so-and-so, right? And, you know, I just wanted to reach out to you today. You were on my mind. And I just wanted to ask how I can pray for you today. And so what happens if that opens the door and Vinny says, well, wow, that's kind of strange, but yeah, sure, you can pray for me. And just simply ask, Vinny, like, what specifically is going on in your life currently? Like, what can I ask God to help you with? And Vinny might open right up and share. He might say, hey, you know what? Here's what's happening right now. Pray for my second cousin or whatever. And then you could just begin to pray for that. But what happens if Vinny goes, well, what are you talking about? What do you mean, can I pray for you? Well, do you know that I'm a Christian? And you know what? This is what Jesus said for us to do, to pray for one another. That's how you love one another. And you know, you're related to me, Vinny. You're my second cousin. And I just want to ask God's best for you today. Is there any way I can just pray over you today? So, how we wrap this up today is think about this. Really make a list. Really jot down some names. Really plan on reaching out to your relative today. And let God love them through you.